Hi everyone, this is Honeywell and I'm playing Banished. This is episode 15 of The Perfect Town. When we last left off, we were trying to get our orchard up and running, so we're going to go ahead and take care of that this episode, as well as all the odds and ends that we have going on around town. It has been a while, so it's going to take me a minute to figure out where we were and what we're doing. It looks like we have more homes than families right now, so we're going to slow down on our house building. Our fishermen are understaffed. We're going to go ahead and raise them up to 26, which we'll put two at every dock. And part of the reason for that is we are growing our population extremely aggressively, as fast as we can. Let's see, 50 years. And while this huge reserve of food over here is nice, that is not going to help for long if we are using more food than we're bringing in. Now, you'll notice that I don't really rely on the Town Hall production tab that much. And that's simply because when you purchase food as heavily as we do, along with the ale production, it doesn't really help us that much. We can see that we're producing less than we're using, and that's consistent each year, but we don't have a shortfall of food. So while this information is great, it's not really helpful for the way that we're running this down. One thing that is helpful is our fuel production, though. You can see that we produced 4,000 last year and we used 4,300. Now, part of the reason why we only produced 4,000 last year was because these stockpiles back here were full and unable to do the numbers that they should. But regardless of that, we're rapidly approaching a point where we're going to start going through our backlog of firewood. 200 wood homes will use roughly 6,000 firewood a year, and we're only producing somewhere around 5,000. So not this episode. But the next episode, we're going to go ahead and start taking care of that. We'll build some more forest hubs, some more woodcutters, and if we need to, we can buy some firewood. And yeah, let's see what is going on. So we have our fishermen up to half. Our gatherers are at half. That's what I was talking about. So even though we're expanding aggressively and we have a large surplus of food, when you consider we have, I don't know, say 600 citizens, so we use about 60,000 food is the good rule of thumb. So we have more than a year's worth of food. We are also working on stockpiling a reserve of food in these trading posts, and we can always increase our labor and produce a lot more than we are right now. We can add an additional 30 farmers, 10 gatherers, another 26 fishermen. That's a lot of extra food that we can quickly produce. So even though I'm placing houses as fast as I can, it's not reckless. always aware of our food, and we're always producing new food sources as we do this. Okay, we're also going to stock this trading post with the essentials, basically, 9,000 food of every food group, and the apples, beans, fish, and wheat are the four food items that we want the most of in our town. And that just increases the chance that each house will have one of the four food groups, and everyone will be slightly healthier. It's not a guarantee, but when you have a large quantity of one food, the market stocks a large quantity of that food. So you'll see we'll have 1,300 apples, beans, a lot of wheat, not a lot of fish for some reason, but hopefully adding those few extra vendors the last episode will take care of that. Okay, and we also want 500 steel tools and 500 warm coats. And we really don't have the warm coats to stock. So I think we'll go ahead and put in another tailor as well. And this one's just about finished. And we'll put this tailor over at this marketplace here. Okay. And maybe a well back here. This episode is going to be a nice, slow, and relaxing one. I'm not in any hurry to get anything done. And we're just going to go around, take a look at what needs to be done, and kind of fill in the gaps. And we'll also start building some houses soon. I'm playing at a lower speed, so not a lot is going to happen quickly. But our population is rising, and will continue to rise. Because of the aggressive way that we're building the houses. I'll put some roads. Yeah, that's fine the way it is. Looks like our new cemetery is finished. And I guess we can cap this end off with a well. We're definitely far from any water at this end, so we could use them. And maybe we'll put another over here. I guess that's fine. We're starting to get to the point of the game where disasters seem to happen more frequently. Or at least that's what I've found. I think there might even be a something in the game code that kind of prevents natural disasters for a while. Let's see here. I guess that's good. And another well. I think we filled in some roads around here last time. And again, we're already going through all the stone we just got. So hopefully there'll be more along shortly. Oh, you know what? That's something else that I wanted in here. So we're definitely going to be using more. Well, we'll wait until these are warm coats, one other tailor. I'll be stocking this trading post with exactly what we have in this one. So we'll want to put another 500 stone and 250 iron in here, but that can wait, because I don't want to leave us short while we're building right now. There's plenty for them to work on. And okay, this trading post is 100% full. And in this one, again, we have the 36,000 reserve of food, and we have 6,000 firewood. And these, again, we're just stockpiling these goods for, I keep saying, in case there was a disaster, like a tornado or a disease. This is our first disease. But really, the chances are I would need to use this if, because of user error, really. A lot of times you might get towards the end game and you might play at a faster speed than you would usually. Getting something to eat, great. And it makes it hard to spot any trouble that you might get yourself into if you're playing at 10 times speed. And he's visiting the doctor. We'll have to see how this works out. Now, this hospital isn't in an ideal location just because it's right next to a graveyard where people are naturally going to idle. But I wasn't sure that there was really a good place for this hospital anywhere in this section. It's going to be densely populated. And you have vendors and traders moving around all the time. So you want your hospitals to be kind of off the beaten track, so not everyone is passing by them. But they can't be too far away, or unless your people will die on their way to the hospital and just infect that many more people as they're getting treated. And honestly, I've tried putting hospitals as out of the way as I possibly could, and it didn't seem to have much effect. What happens is the diseases are designed to spread. Most of the diseases have an 8-tile radius. But some of them are as high as as 12 tiles. And Banished is a game where there really isn't that much land available for you to kind of reserve a 10-tile radius around each hospital. And again, people infect everyone on their way to the hospitals or doing whatever else they're doing. So the thing that I found is to have hospitals in each populated area, so people who live over here don't have to travel to get over here to go to a hospital. And the second thing I found was just having a healthy population seems to help a bit. I'm not sure if there's a game mechanic where health impacts the rate that diseases get spread. I know that a sick population can increases your likelihood of spawning a disease. Killed by a falling tree. But I'm not sure if once you already have an outbreak, if it's less likely for a healthy citizen to be infected or not. But that's just what seems to work for me. Keeping the population healthy and spreading out the hospitals in all the populated areas of town, even if they're not ideal, even if they're kind of butted up next to a cemetery that naturally attracts idlers. And our first disaster of the episode is already done. I think we had up to 5 people became infected. They were all treated, and yeah. That's all there was to that. And we have our Taylor up. And we're going to start unpausing these houses here. Just so we can get our orchard planted. And with these, I'm going to go ahead and raise the worker count up to 4. Not because I am going to... Oh, but you know what? It's spring and they just started planting, so I don't want to mess that up by having these start. But we'll go ahead and get these raised up here. The reason why I'm raising these up to 4 workers is to match the farm fields. I'm going to keep my farmers at half of the total that I need. And that's going to put 2 workers per field on here. Now, if food becomes an issue and I need to start producing more, then the first thing that I would do is probably raise my farmers up to 3 farmers a field, which would max out my orchards over here, And at the same time, it would increase the workers on these fields to 3, which would give them enough, just that extra little boost, just to make sure that we're getting every last bit of the crops harvested. The way we have our farm fields set up with so many barns and so many houses nearby, 2 workers are usually enough to get in the full harvest. A third worker would kind of guarantee that. So by increasing these to 4, I never have any intention of actually having 4 farmers on an orchard field. It's just 2. Just to make the math easier over here to manage this. I hope that makes sense. I know it's kind of rambling. It makes sense to me, though. Okay, good. No students back here. And none here yet either. And here we can we can see how these were glitching out. You can see that this ground, there's no road over it, but if you use your remove road tool, you can see that there is invisible roads here. And if I were going to try and plant a crop, you could see that this would be a green tile here. But all of this is unusable because of that road. Now, I can go ahead and remove the road. And you can see that tile is green again. But the land is permanently corrupted. The only thing that can be placed here now is roads. So I'm going to go ahead and fill this space in with some dirt roads. And just have to live with it. But I am definitely never deleting any unfinished roads after I've saved again. That is for sure. And as soon as we have these two houses full and it's wintertime, we'll go ahead and turn those orchards on and get them planted. Finally. And that way, while I'm fiddling around with the workers and everything, it's not going to mess with these harvests in any way. And we're also going to work on getting this area up and running. We'll unpause these barns. I guess we'll unpause all these as well. And maybe split some more of these. Do sheep and sheep. I only want a little bit of cattle for the leather. And you know, I'll split this one twice. Cannot see it all here. Oh no, okay, it's formed. And I've left room right here for a second row of barns. Just in case we need them, I've found that in the late game you can never have too much storage, especially in an unmodded game where the barns only hold 6,000. In a modded game, your town would probably look a lot different. Rows and rows and rows of storage barns probably wouldn't be necessary. But as you can see, even with all of these storage barns, these ones are pretty empty. But we only have less than 600 citizens, so the amount of food and resources that we're storing is a lot less. Once the population rises, all of the amount of food that we're going to need to produce and buy is going to go up. And we'll need the room. So even though it doesn't look as nice as I would like it to, I really hate all the barns like this. But better to plan for them now than to scurry around later trying to fit barns into every nook and cranny. good. This is full, so yeah. Let's see. And these are filling up. We're gonna go ahead and see if we can empty out some of the firewood from here. I'm assuming that these stockpiles would be closer. We'll go ahead and up the pace a little bit there too. And the barn is still good. Let's see. Okay, yeah, they're filling up the stockpile, so that's fine. And we'll take a look at the buildings back here so you can kind of see what we're producing. Two gatherers back here are really doing pretty good. It's almost 2,000. Let's see, and getting about 300 logs. That's not bad. Then yeah, the same, about 2,000 food with two gatherers, which is great. Our hunting cabins aren't doing as well, but that's okay. Last time we played, I was thinking about getting rid of this herbalist hut, and I think I'm gonna do that. And we'll lower those. It'll give this a little bit more forest for the forester and herbalist. I'm sure it won't make much of a difference, but we really don't need it, so I'm over to claim that. Okay, and now that it's winter, we'll go ahead and put all of these orchards to work, and we'll increase our farmers. Was it 116 farmers? So that's 58. And those are fine. And those are fine. Okay, it looks like our little spurt in population has finally caught up. And we can build at least about 18 houses without even worrying about it. So we'll go ahead and get these houses unpaused. And we'll take these off our screen. Okay, so that's 9 more houses. Which is a lot. You'll see we have two workers on all of these fields. Now I'm assuming that's going to be, well, one, you only need one worker to start an orchard. One worker can and plant the whole field. And it's really not until till you start harvesting these that you would need more labor. So if you were short on labor, you could absolutely wait, put one worker on your fields, get the trees planted, and then wait the 3 years until they start yielding fruit to put your farmers back on there. But I honestly don't care. We have more than enough labor, 87 for such a small population, so that's not something that I'm going to do. But it's definitely an option. And all of that stone is just about gone already. And we still have a ton of stone roads that haven't been put in. So we'll hope that a stone merchant arrives before we run out. Or I guess I could collect some of this over here too. And put that ton of labor that we have to work. Okay, this area back here is actually where I'm going to put a couple mines and some quarries. Eventually. As soon as I get around to it. I think the next episode, we'll go ahead and plan out the quarries over here. And this section of the town is going to be forest hubs. So we'll put another two, maybe we'll get our mining up and running, and then another two, at least two forest hubs back in this area planned out. And I think we'll probably also think about switching over to stone houses at some point. We're really not going to have a choice, I don't think. And for one, stone houses have I believe it's 30% chance, less chance of spreading a fire than wooden houses, which isn't much, but it does help, so, especially around your marketplaces and stuff. Now, I also know that that some people like to leave a fire break around their marketplaces, and what's accepted as good enough is four spaces. So that's something that you might consider. I honestly don't know that. When a fire happens, I just suck it up and whatever gets damaged. I rebuild and move on. Without even really, I don't know, it's just no big deal to me. But I know for others, you kind of get really mad when your town keeps burning down over and over again. So if you're into prevention, that's something that you might do, is leave four spaces and then start building your houses. Because the houses are always what seems to catch on fire. Look at our population. Yeah, we're still doing good. And we're up over 600 citizens. So what would that be? 600 citizens. We're a village now. So, yay village? I don't know. This looks pretty big to me. Looks like a little bit bigger than a village. Yeah, and I'm running into, like, little bits of, I don't know, almost like lag. I don't know that I've never recorded anything before or played a game while I was recording, but I'm wondering if I'm going to be able to record this as long as I had planned to. Because if we're only at 600 population and it's already starting to feel a little laggy on 2x speed, I'm not sure what it's going to be like when the population really gets high. We'll see. My intention was to build the population as high as we wanted it. I don't know which I expected to be around at least the. Oh, we have another disease. This time typhus. And I'm pretty sure typhus falls pretty much in the middle of the pack. There are some diseases that are extremely infectious and deadly. I think the worst is the plague, obviously. Cholera is another one that is extremely infectious and deadly. And then on your more least deadly and less infectious, I think influenza and diptheria are kind of the more mild diseases. And I think typhus falls just about in the middle. Actually, I'll go ahead and put that in the description. A list of the diseases and how deadly they are. And whatever other information is in the mod files for those. And it looks like this hospital is getting a lot of work. Oh, someone died in childbirth. They had half a heart, less health. Where do you live? What, you have food? Let's see. Fruit, meat, vegetable, and wheat. Okay. You're missing a full heart, though. Yes, you only have fruit and fish. You're covered by the marketplace, though. Fruit and fish. I kind of made sure of that when I put you in there. Yeah, it is what it is. And that's why I want the herbalists around. Just because sometimes what happens is, I don't know, people die. And then their houses, people just move in and kind of use whatever is stockpiled in their houses. Or maybe they went to the market and there wasn't anything really there. I don't know. But for some reason, the houses aren't always perfectly stocked, even though there's a variety of food available. We're up to 2 infected. So that's why I try and include the herbalists in each section of the town. I'm not concerned at all with how many herbs they're gathering. If for some reason this number would drop down, I would simply buy herbs from the traders. But these guys who aren't covered with, like these houses right here, they're not covered by a marketplace, and they are perfectly content, it looks like, to just eat fish. For reasons. Hopefully the next time they need firewood or a tool or something, they'll wander down to the marketplace here and pick up a bigger variety of a food. But if they don't, the herbalist is right there, and that should keep their health around the 4-star range. They're not as sick as they should be. Give it time, though. And we're up to 5. Let's see if this disease passes just as quick. There's an awful lot of people over here in that graveyard. Probably because it's winter. So I'm going to queue up these trees to be harvested, and hopefully if those are idle laborers, they'll go. Yeah, it's all the farmers. So let's harvest a few more trees. Hopefully that'll empty out the graveyard. Oh, and we have our first death from typhus. And all of these people are doing a good job of hanging around the hospital and infecting themselves. Oh, and that person's going to school, and this one's going to the marketplace. Yeah. I'm guessing this outbreak is going to be a little bit more severe than the mumps one. And these are just about up to speed. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and I guess we'll leave this pasture back here as our backup pasture. And we'll fill in these two while we're at it. Might as well split. And split. Okay. 5 and 10. Great. Might as well fill those all in while we're... while we don't really need the food. Although, our food is dropping. And it looks like these people are bound and determined to infect everybody. Oh, the poor child. And we got in another shipment of stone, so I'm gonna go ahead and take 500 of that for our trading post. And we have a bit of iron, so we're gonna add that to this as well. Let's see how of our coats doing. By me, please. Warm coats, we have like none. But there's wool coats in stock, and as soon as they're done stocking this trading post, I'm assuming they'll catch up again. And that is death number 2 from Typhus. I thought typhus was kind of a middle-of-the-road disease, but we have 2 people dead already, so maybe it's a little higher up on the list than I thought. We're going to be stocking some... We're going to be stocking tools in I'm out of practice with the math there and that trading post, so I'm going to go ahead and buy some of that stuff there. Oh, we're down to 2 infected, but this person is wandering all over creation. Oh, yeah, great. You're visiting the doctor. And you are working. So, yeah. Just when you thought it was over. And are all of our houses built over here? They are. Here is something I don't know that I've used on camera before. The pathing tool is great. I don't know, I'm pretty, I don't use it as much now as I used to, but it still comes in handy as a quick check just to make sure there's enough housing available in the area. And there seems to be. Let's check out our orchards. Well, that's kind of bad. Eh, they're not too bad. This is obvious. These orchards, we'll have to see the first harvest whether or not they're capable of getting in the full harvest. I think they are, but these houses definitely aren't butted up right next to the field, so they might need more help. I'm not really concerned about it. You know what, but since we are... since we are putting in all those orchards, maybe we need a few more taverns. Let's do that. We'll put in some more taverns. Well, they're not getting hardly anything anyway, so... that's something that I haven't done in a while. I haven't gone around to each of the buildings and clicked on them so you guys could see what everything is being produced. Maybe we'll do that. Maybe we'll do that and call this an episode. I know it's running on a little long. Well, a lot long. So I guess we could do that, right? Let's see, what are the taverns? 160, 370, 10. Obviously, there's a problem there. 2080. What is going on? 240. Do you see how this is ridiculously low for no apparent reason? Like that they produce 10. Whatever is going on with say, like this tavern right here, that's producing 30 ale. My guess is maybe they were sick. That's the only reason why I can think that some of these taverns are producing so little. But whatever the reason, that's whatever is going on with these workers. Maybe there's just not apples nearby. Yeah, I don't see any apples. I guess we're not ordering enough? Oh yeah, we're down to 11,000 apples. Well, that would be why. So these people are probably having to walk all over creation to... to get their apples. Oh, and there's our third person who died of typhus. Oh, it was a child. So I guess this orchard will come in handy for the times when the apples reserve gets a little low. It could also be, you know what, that's probably what's going on as well. We're stocking the trading post and it looks like they're working on apples right now. So they're probably taking all of the local supply. Okay, so that was that. We looked at these buildings just a moment ago. And 354. And just about 2,000, maybe? What, 4, 12, maybe 1,800 for the two gatherers over here, which is pretty good because this is probably one of the smaller circles they have to work with because of the mountains, as well as some of the fishing hut buildings encroaching, not to mention the school and all these houses, but they still produce a decent amount of food. And the hunting cabin is pathetic, but again, I don't have any control over that, really. And they did good. 1,200 last year. School. Let's see, what else do we have? Oh, this hospital's getting used. It looks like these are the last two people. Unless all these idlers and whatnot are going to get infected. And yeah, not bad. Only two fishermen, but they're pulling in over 1,000. Do a quick barn check too. These barns are so close to the center of the town, they're usually fine, but you should check on them every once in a while. And we're down to our last diseased patient. Let's see if that dies out now or if more people are going to get infected. Nope, there's two. And almost 1,000. Fish here. 1,100 there. $13.41 here. That's actually probably our best fishing dock then. Part of that is they're right next to a marketplace, and I've always found, I don't know if it's the marketplace vendors come up here frequently and haul the fish away, or if it's just they're in a area that has so many free laborers. But all of my fishing docks that are near marketplaces seem to do better than others, regardless of water coverage. These are pretty pathetic, but I'm betting these traders are in some of these houses. Okay. So, where are all the fishermen living? They're all up here. So they have a little bit of a walk, more than others. What about you guys? Yeah. Or it might just be that's what they're going to produce. But still, 812 for two people. It's not bad. And it takes up hardly no room whatsoever. And again, pretty good. 1,100, two people. And that's pretty low. But it's also a small patch of water, too, so. And 868 there. I tried to position this bridge so it wouldn't impact these circles much. And I think I actually did a pretty good job, but they do encroach a little bit, I think. And what are you producing? You're producing a fair amount. And they're still only eating fish, though. Oh, no. Okay, so this house at least went to the marketplace. So I'm assuming they'll do the same with this one. Eventually, they'll have to go to the marketplace for something, and they'll pick up a wider variety of goods. Oh, and our second disease is done. And the builder just fell off a ladder and died. You have to be careful. Okay, this has been an extremely long episode, I think. I actually don't have a timer. I just kind of play until what I wanted accomplished got done. But it is year 41. We have almost 700. Nope. We have over 600 citizens. We had two diseases today. That even though the hospitals were in less than kind of ideal places, you saw that it didn't become like an uncontrolled epidemic where everyone was sick constantly, even though there's people that idle outside of them and one's butted up right next to a graveyard. So it's just been in my experience, you don't have to go too crazy trying to place your hospitals in far-flung places, because I don't know that it really helps. I think that if you put them so out of the way, your sick will just infect people along the way. I haven't noticed any benefit from keeping the hospitals completely isolated. So I just kind of tuck them in, not butted up right close to a marketplace. And again, I didn't want to put this kind of like along this main road where everyone walks up and down trading. So you don't want to be stupid about it, but I don't think that you need to completely go out of your way to isolate your hospitals. But again, that's just my opinion. Anything you want to do is fine, and it will work. But this is just what I do, so that's what you get to see. Again, I'll put all of the disease information in the description. And when we come back in episode 16, we'll maybe consider getting those forest hubs we were talking about up and running, and maybe our little mining town as well. Okay, thank you for watching, and I hope you'll come back for episode 16.